In this video, I'm going to introduce three simple things that you can do right now today in order to make your WordPress website fly. I'm talking all about speed today, making your slow website into a fast website. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. I upload these daily, and if you enjoy the content in this video, I'd like you to consider clicking on that subscribe button. So let's just go ahead and get in. Now, the funny thing about this is I've actually covered all of these topics before in videos. Now, the thing is, I know when you go to my YouTube channel, I have so many videos here available for you, you might not realize everything that is there. So the three things that I'm going to share with you today are going to be very easy. You can implement these today and you can benefit from a faster website. And it is so important and so crucial that your website is fast, because if it's slow, I gotta break some news to you. I'm gonna leave. If I go to your website and it takes over 3 or 4 or 5 seconds to load, I am out of there. I mean, I am gone, and I'm not gonna sit around and wait. And the people that are coming to your website, they're not gonna sit around and wait either. So it is super duper important that you have a fast website. So the first thing we're going to do to make your website fly is to upgrade the PHP version that you have on your web hosting account. Now, the nice thing about YouTube, you can actually click through to my channel, click on the videos tab, and then there's this search option right here. If you do a search for the word speed, right here, it's actually the second video, how to make your WordPress website run faster by changing one setting. And this video is all about changing the PHP version on your website. Now, I know that is a super technical, geeky acronym thing, PHP, blah, blah, blah. All you need to know is that you're probably on an old version. You have control to upgrade it to a more recent version. I cover it step by step in this video, and it really only takes a few minutes to implement. And this is really where you learn whether the person you're listening to on YouTube knows what the heck they're talking about. I watched a video recently where someone compared all these different web hosting accounts, and I thought that was pretty interesting, but he wasn't making sure that they were all set the same, especially when it comes to this PHP version. Now, some web hosts, not a lot of them, a very select few of them, when you get a new web hosting account, they're going to put you on PHP version 7 by default. But the vast majority of web hosts are not going to do that. And the reason is, there may be some compatibility issues if you want to be on the more recent version. So they usually put you on version 5.6. All of this is explained in this video, and it's very easy to consume. And I even teach you how to find out if you're going to have any problems. Now, any well-coded WordPress theme or plugin should have absolutely no problems under PHP version 7. And it is so much faster, and it's going to make your website load so much faster. And in the back end of WordPress, it's going to make that so much faster. So go ahead, go to my website. I actually put links to these videos in the notes section of this video, but you can come to the channel here and do a search. It's super easy. I meant to show you that right here. Here's a little search icon. You can click on that. It reveals this little option here to search any of the videos on this channel. So if you do a search for the word speed, it's going to pull these up. And you might want to take a look at some of these other videos right here. I'm going to teach you how to test the speed of your website. But this right here where it says double speed in one setting, this is the video that's going to show you how to upgrade your PHP version with your web host. Now, also, some web hosts might not make it so easy. And in those scenarios, all you have to do most likely is to submit a support ticket to your web host and say, hey, can you upgrade me to PHP version 7? But you'll see in this video, you don't have to do that. It's actually in your control panel. Super easy to implement. Any good web hosting and company is going to give you the option to upgrade to PHP 7. And the best part is you can easily go back down to the version that you were on. You're not committed to being on version 7. The speed is going to be huge for you though. Okay, let's move on to number two. Number two is to optimize your images. And it's the same thing. You can search for the word images. And here is the video right here, how to optimize WordPress images. Now, I'm actually most likely going to be updating this video at some point really soon. So you might see a different one on this topic. And it will most likely be the first one that shows. Oh, and forgive me for some of these old thumbnail images. I'm going through updating them all. Images are so important. What people do, the mistakes they make with images is they upload images that are too large. So if you are getting, say, an image from pixels, I actually have a video on here to find how to find the best free images. Typically when you download it, it's in this huge size, way too large for what you need. So the problem with images is people don't reduce the size a little bit of those images to just the size that they need, and they don't optimize those images. There are free services that you can run your image through, and it will reduce the size of that image by sometimes up to 75%. So it's definitely something that is slowing your website down. Images that are too large and images that are not optimized. Now, I am putting together a comprehensive video on image sizes for WordPress websites that's going to cover every aspect of images, not where to get them. I already have that covered right here. But what to do with them once you have them, and the best way to get them plugged into your WordPress website. I'm going to be talking about sizes of images. I'm going to be talking about also optimizing those images. Now, when I made this video right here, you can see it's a little old, 2 years ago. All the information is relevant. I'm going to go over a free web-based solution that you can run your images through before you upload them to your WordPress website. Also, now there's a lot of different services that can get right into your WordPress website via a plugin, and they all do the same thing pretty much. They optimize your images all in the same way, and they all have different price points. But I'm going to show you free resources in this video on how to optimize the size of your images. Last, number three, we're going to talk about caching. You do need a WordPress caching solution for your website. When you search for the word caching, right here, WordPress caching overview, it is right there. And in this video, I talk about some of the different caching solutions for your WordPress website. Essentially, what caching does is the way your WordPress website works is you got these static files here. These are these WordPress files, and then you have a database. And whenever someone visits your website, the WordPress goes to the database and starts pulling out info to show to them. What caching does is it eliminates most of that communication and that slowdown where WordPress has to go and get the data to show. It will make a static copy of it that it can just show them almost instantaneously. This would probably make one of the biggest speed boosts on your website by just implementing caching on your WordPress website. Now, there's also some free plugins for this, and they're actually pretty good ones. And there's also a primary paid solution called WPCrafter. I personally use WPCrafter. I'm not saying that's the one you have to use. You could probably totally get by just fine using one of these free plugin solutions to speed up your website. So this video, I have covered three things that you can do right now to speed up your website dramatically. This is something you need to pay attention to. This is something you need to make happen on your website. Now, if there is something that you think I should have included on this list and I didn't, go ahead and leave a comment down below. Share with me your secrets to make your website lightning quick. I do know there's one thing I didn't talk about, and that's a content delivery network. I should do a video on that. Maybe I'll add that in the description as a bonus. And also, it should go without saying, your web host has a good part to play with it. If you're using a crummy web host, you can definitely improve your speed by getting a better web hosting company. I have some that I recommend, and I'll put links down to those below. And lastly, I do cover speed in much more detail in a course that I have on my website, a training course called WordPress Optimization Essentials. And I have had students go into that course with websites that take 10 or 12 seconds to load. And after they go through the course, they get it under 2 seconds, many times under 1 second to load. But anyways, I didn't want to overwhelm you. These are the three best tips that you can implement right now to make your WordPress website fly.